And Dr. Tanu Jindal is a very eminent and experienced person in the sphere, the space of lactation management. And I must say that, you know, she, in the past few years, she's been looking at a digital module for teaching lactation. And I think that is the essence of what she's going to be doing today. Digitally, how do we support breastfeeding women? Yes, thank you so much. I must say, Dr. Jindal, it was work to compress or see into one slide. I hope I have done it justice. Arul Jindal, in addition to the medical qualifications, extensively trained lactation management internationally. She's part of the International Board of Certified Lactation Consultants, and she is trained with Breastfeeding Advocacy and Training course in Malaysia with a WABA's fellowship to train under the best global best breastfeeding experts, Sandra Lang and Felicity Savage. She has a huge impactful body of work, and one is extensive breastfeeding skills for health professionals, over 2,500 health professionals across 12 districts in Maharashtra, as well as across states. I think that's extremely commendable work. She also has her own YouTube channel. You must give us a name and link to it after your session, Dr. Taru. And she has got about 34 different breastfeeding videos. She's a pioneer in the practice of breast crawl because she started it as she was doing her residency. And I think she will touch upon that in her session for today. Apart from that, she is digitally supporting a lot of women, mother support group on WhatsApp, Breastfeeding Matters. She started it. She started Mama's Dudu. That's so sweet. Mother support
group on WhatsApp. Ma'am, the digital part I will be covering in the presentation now. The digital
groups. Yes. No, I'm just sharing with the participants the work you have done. That's it. So also she's authored a web series on Facebook, Lactation Matters, and she's got recipient of various awards. I am only stating two over here from her large repertoire. She's awarded with the Most Inspiring Woman of the Year for valuable contribution in the field of healthcare by the Global Women Achiever Awards at Mumbai. And she's been awarded the Karambi Chakra in 2019 by I Congo and United Nations at Delhi. So welcome, Dr. Taru Jindal. We are waiting to listen to what you have to share. Please take it forward.
Namaste, namaste all of you. And this is the last day of the World Breastfeeding Week. And I think this time's Breastfeeding Week, it has been, I haven't seen a Breastfeeding Week like this before, wherein there are so many webinars happening. You just don't have the time to follow up on everyone, which proves that the awareness level and the advocacy has worked so well. Nirmala Niketan, I think with them, I gave one more talk in 2018. And I have been following the work of their professors and lecturers over the last few years as a part of few WhatsApp groups. And I think their food and nutrition department is doing a lot of good work. Thanks a lot. And thanks a lot for this opportunity. So I will just share the screen. And along with that, I'll give my talk. Yeah, so the topic that I thought I should take now is how virtual platforms like online platforms or phone platforms can transform breastfeeding support for breastfeeding mothers. So how did it start for me? It started for me actually as a need, because in 2016, till 2016, I was working one-to-one with the patients, with the mothers. But I fell ill and I had to find a way to keep connected, to stay connected to mothers.
Excuse me, Dr. Taru. Excuse me, Dr. Taru.
Yeah.
I will request you to put your video off because of the bandwidth issue. It'll be better if you put your video off.
Yes, I will do that. My video off. Okay, stop video. Fine? This is fine?
Yes, Dr.
This is
Taru.
Fine,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, it's fine. Let's go ahead.
Yeah. So I started work on online platforms as a way of trying to reach out to mothers from within the four walls of my house. Because of my illness, I couldn't move out. And slowly I kept thinking, ki, how can I connect to mothers? How can I reach out? So the first thing I did in 2017 was to start writing a Facebook blog on breastfeeding called Lactation Matters. So in this, I, from my own experience, little bit myths and taboos and confusions that I observed in mothers through my experience in clinical field, I started writing small posts about it, and I saw that they were getting very, they were just getting lapped up by mothers. So that's when I realized that that online platforms do reach out, and that was my first such experience. The second thing that I did was that when I completed my IBCLC and I got the degree, it gave me a lot of confidence to go ahead to manage the mothers. So I started work on two different parameters. First was, of course, practicing lactation practice and taking care of mothers. The second was to make a mother support group on WhatsApp. So why did I do it? I did it initially because I realized that the mothers that I was managing in my lactation practice, I used to think, what is happening to them after our sessions are over? Because another 2 to 3 years of breastfeeding is left for them. And how will they be supported at that time? So I initially started this group in order to provide them long-term support, even though they were not coming to me as professional clients. And then slowly more mothers started getting added, and this became a full-fledged group. So in the last 2.5 years or so, this group has supported more than 400 Indian women across the globe. And whenever someone leaves the group, the emotion that they usually express is, we would not have been able to continue for this group. So I realized that initially, I had just started this group as a way of providing information and resources. As you can see the description, support of breastfeeding mothers through scientific evidence-based information. That was the goal. But slowly, I realized that this group was meaning a lot more to the mothers than just a place for information. Because I could see, like in the morning when I'll get up, I'll see at 3 o'clock, two mothers have been chatting on the group. So this group provided a sense of companionship, because breastfeeding can often be very lonely for the mother. Everyone is sleeping, only she's getting up and breastfeeding at night. And her old life has gone, her circumstances have suddenly changed. So that can be incredibly lonely for the mother. So this group tells her that I am not alone. There are 257 other mothers who are exactly in the same boat as me. And many times mothers would write something that I have this issue, then another mother would write back, oh, don't worry, I also had this issue. You can see this video, you will get some idea. Or they will share some number of lactation consultants. So I realized that not just for providing resources, but also for emotional support. And third, for appreciation. Because somewhere breastfeeding is seen as isme kya badi baat hai, sab karte hain breastfeeding to. So probably mothers don't receive that much appreciation for the amount of hard work they have to do in those 2 to 3 years. So this group is a great source of ego boost for them. So it really taught me, as a lactation consultant, as a mother supporter, as an advocate, a lot of things that no textbook, nothing could have taught me, not even my work in the hospital could have taught me. Because these were discussions beyond hospital. There were so many things being talked about, and I think I became a better lactation supporter after the group. So such groups, many such groups have been created. For example, in Facebook, you have BSIM, Breastfeeding Support for Indian Mothers, and that has done like phenomenal work with thousands of women, right? So this is a smaller group, but very effective because it was on WhatsApp and very easily reachable. What happened was, after a lot of mothers completed their 2 years of breastfeeding and were leaving the group, so they started expressing their wish that we also want to help other mothers. I was thinking, how could they help other mothers. So we formed a WhatsApp group called Breastfeeding Buddies. And in this, we started pairing a senior mother, senior means who has almost reached the end of lactation, with a new mother who has just given birth or is just very new to it, right? So when we paired them, I'll just share an experience. A mother said that when I started receiving calls from my breastfeeding buddy, so they were paired and they were together for roughly 3 months. And she started calling her weekly from, I think, when the baby was 3 weeks old. So weekly calls, and in the calls, a lot of emotional support and proper resource sharing. I think this really helped. And then the mother knew that, oh, I have someone to call if I have any issue. Sometimes mothers don't feel very comfortable writing something on WhatsApp, or they might find it a little impersonal. So this calling system really helped, and that helped her in exclusively breastfeeding for 6 months. And now she herself has become a breastfeeding buddy. So this was a beautiful thing that we tried online. The next thing that I tried was, I realized we are helping breastfeeding mothers, but the problems start because we are not targeting the right time. We have to target the mothers when they are pregnant, and we have to take all the skills of breastfeeding, all the information during pregnancy, so that they are prepared, they are sensitized. So I started a mother support group called as Mama's Dudu, and we had training sessions over 4 days. Every month I take it, and the mothers who get trained in the breastfeeding training sessions become a part of Mama's Dudu, and of course many of them deliver. So one of the responses of a mother who delivered in from the group was that, I was prepared so well that now at 2 months, of course she had some problems, at 2 months I am exclusively breastfeeding, wherein I see all my friends, one or the other supplement like formula, cow milk is going on. So just by online support, we were able to get a mother to exclusive breastfeeding. Lastly, I think I realized that there is no alternative of good resources and good information. So that's the foundation of breastfeeding support. So I take a lot of webinars, and so I made small capsules of important stuff and the interviews that I have been taking on World Breastfeeding Week, and I put them all on this YouTube channel. My name is Dr. Taru Jindal. So you can find videos on lots of topics, but under the breastfeeding topic, you can see 18 videos, and you can share it with all the mothers and breastfeeding women and their families. So I have shared all this, like I did, I used WhatsApp, I used Facebook, and I used YouTube, the three most common apps on our smartphone. So the only reason I shared all this is because probably now in this COVID era, in the post-COVID era, we have to reevaluate our programs, our plans of working for mothers. We might not be able to directly do one-to-one sessions with them, or have them coming over to the clinic, or some we going over to them. So online support is going to be one of the major ways to reach out to women now. So maybe this may give people ideas. I'd like to give one more example. Dr. Rupal Dalal, she has a along with IIT Mumbai, they have a breastfeeding helpline. So 24/7 help on that. The next thing, I think they also have a health spoken tutorial page on YouTube, in which they have lots of videos. So these are all the ways in which we can provide virtual support to our mothers. I'll just give two, three slides are left on how we have done World Breastfeeding Week this time, just purely online. So the first was advocacy. I tried to share images of mothers who have breastfed for 2 years. You know, this was just to recognize them in public and create a public opinion about breastfeeding that, oh wow, they have breastfed for 2 years, or mothers who have breastfed exclusively for 6 months. When such images come out in social media, it is a strong message to even unmarried girls or to girls who just got married or just got pregnant. It's a strong message. So for advocacy was one of the things we did online. The second thing, of course, was giving lectures. So I gave a lot of lectures during this breastfeeding week, took a lot of expert interviews and a lot of mother interviews. So interestingly, these mothers' interviews have been very popular and they are just going viral. Every day, 200 likes are increasing on the videos because no matter how much the experts and the like people like us will say, only when it comes from the mother's mouth, that is the real thing. And their words are so inspiring. Just today, a mother has penned down a poem about her sense of loss over weaning her child. My God, she has fallen in love with breastfeeding and that act so much that now she's actually feeling a sense of loss when she has to stop breastfeeding. So this is the beauty of breastfeeding, and this is the beauty of advocacy work that people have been doing from across, from so many decades and across the world. So yeah, this is all I had to say about virtual platforms. And I think this is the way to go forward in the COVID era and the post-COVID era. So everyone can take ideas from this and have their own ideas of how they can reach out to women through the online. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Dr. Taru Jindal. Please put your video on for the discussion. Yes.